The assailant was said to have gotten away with approximately $1,000. The armed robbery at the hospital's business office was committed by a lone gunman. Officials at the Saint Jude Hospital confirmed that the institution was robbed at gunpoint early Thursday morning at approximately 3 a.m. Employees on duty at the time of the robbery, panic-stricken by the robber's appearance, immediately called police, who responded. The incident, which is a first for the institution, has renewed calls for the government to act immediately and remove the hospital from where it was temporarily relocated at the George Odlum National Stadium after a fire destroyed the original hospital building in 2009.
To the best of my knowledge, we've never had a previous incident of that sort.
Right. And my final question, does this mean now that the authorities need to speed up the process in the move to get St. Jude's to its proper home, a more secured facility?
Well, I think that that certainly highlights the need that all due diligence should occur. One should always be mindful of the fact that there's certainly, even with the best of intentions, would be logistical constraints. But I think certainly that this, if anything, is a wake-up call that whatever those issues are, we need to try to resolve them as quickly as possible.
The St. Jude Hospital CEO says that staffers are still traumatized by the incident and counseling is being provided for the team members.
Certainly security measures at St. Jude Hospital will have to be reevaluated. We have had a series of debriefings today and we are making a comprehensive assessment of what it is that needs to be done. We expect to be continuing a dialogue with the Ministry of Health, and at the end of the day, we're hopeful that the measures that we will be able to put in place will have a mitigating effect on these kinds of issues.
Dr. Poyot says he's very much surprised by what transpired, as one would usually think that hospitals are safe sanctuaries. Police investigations into the matter are continuing. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.